ربنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. الحمد لله. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most compassionate, most merciful, thumma alhamdulillah. We are now in the blessed month of Zulhijjah, and we just completed our congregational prayers of Jama'ah, and we hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah and bless all of us, including those of among our loved ones, our asatiza. Right now, perhaps they are in the midst of performing their Hajj. It is narrated from Ibn Umar, from our beloved Prophet Muhammad SAW, peace be upon him, "For there aren't any days greater, nor any days in which deeds done in them are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High. There aren't any days greater, nor any days in which deeds done in them, in that particular month, are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, than these 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. These 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, any form of amal, of ibadah, as mentioned by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is much more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than any other days. So our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, so increase in them the saying of tahlil, la ilaha illallah, takbir, Allahu akbar, tahmid, alhamdulillah. This hadith is from Musnad Imam Ahmad. So what are the amal or ibadah? Of course, the main climax will be the performing of Hajj. So those who don't perform their Hajj in this first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, then it is much encouraged for you to fast during these days, because any form of ibadah during the first 10 days, it is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than any other days. If you can't the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah or the first 9 days of Dhul-Hijjah, then the day of Arafah is what being asked of, for us to perform our fast of sunnah. Then of course, for us to always glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make takbir, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is also another amal which Allah loves most in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. What else can we perform? Amal, good deeds, making tawbah, repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Astaghfirullah, making tawbah. What else can we perform ibadah? So many things. Of course, stand in your prayers, improve and increase your nawafil prayers, your sunnah prayers, for the sake of looking for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rida. What else? There's a few more in performing your ibadah. And for every Wednesday session, Dhuhr, we are now discussing on the manners, the book of manners. What I would like to share will be the manners of making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the manners of supplication. The manners of supplication, supplication means invocation. Invocation in terms of Arabic calls ad-dua. Now most of us from time to time we are making dua. In fact, we've discussed last year what does as-salah mean. Salah, prayer, means ad-dua in literal meaning. So in this day of Dhul-Hijjah, it is much encouraged for us to make dua. Now when we make dua, there's two different aspects that one need to know between making dua and reading dua. Subhanallah. Making a mere dua, making dua or ask and reading dua. Because when you make your dua, invocation, supplication, the true dua comes from the heart. Comes from the heart. But once you just to read dua, it is what normally you tend to memorize those texts in Arabs, in Arabic texts, and then you just read it out without feel that you are invoking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because that comes from the heart. So it is much more encouraged for me, for all of us, to be blessed, to be in this blessed month of Zulhijjah, the first 10 months. One of the good deeds for us to perform is to make sincere dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبُ لَكُمْ. And your Lord said, invoke me, make dua to me, believe in my oneness, and I will respond to your invocation. I will fulfill your dua. This is actually the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. Udu'uni astajib lakum. Make dua to me, I will fulfill your dua. Likewise, when Allah teach about the manners of dua, what are the manners of dua? How do you make dua? وَقَالَ تَعَالَى بِالْكِتَابِ الْعَزِيزِ قَالَ تَعَالَى in Surah Al-A'raf, أُدُعُوا رَبَّكُمْ تَضَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَةً إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُقْتَدِينَ إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. Surah Al-A'raf, ayah number 55. Just listen to what Allah said. How do you make dua? أُدُعُوا رَبَّكُمْ, invoke to your Lord, Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tadarru'an. There are two attributes. Tadarru'an, with humility. Total humbleness, humility. Wa khufya, quietly. Don't shout what you want from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa Allah, wa Allah. Wa Allah. Feel the humility that you have so many sins. That's what Allah taught us. How do you make dua, the manners of dua? Innahu la yuhibbul mu'tadin. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like the aggressors. Likewise, my brothers and sisters, when you make dua, it is of course the best dua comes from the dua of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. You make dua, that dua comes from what our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dua. Now if you were to know, most of us perhaps, they have in one form or another a book of dua, perhaps in your home or in any of masajid. The book of dua from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And you have to open it, you have a series of dua that comes from our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. And right up from the morning, from the way how our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam enter the mosque, when he leave the mosque, even enter the washrooms, all filled with dua of the beloved Prophet ﷺ. So it is best for us to make use of what being read by our beloved Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. One of the dua that we shared before will be the dua when you completed your prayers. When you completed your prayers, every prayers, you will hear the imam read out, Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Now, we heard that before time and again. And we follow the imam, Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik, Allahumma a'inna, time and again, every single, after completing your congregational prayers, your jama'ah prayers. But if only you were to understand the content of the dua, it will certainly felt by you that what are the meaning that you invoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O Allah, O Allah, Allahumma a'inni, assist me, or assist us. Allahumma a'inni, assist us in remembering you always. Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika, to remember you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And who's the best person to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 24/7? 24/7, subhanallah, the best role model is our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. And he himself taught Sayyidina Mu'az, one of the companions, don't you leave this dua after every salah. You invoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, assist me in remembering you. In always in the state of remembrance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa shukrika, And O Allah, assist me also to be grateful to you. To be the servants of Allah who is grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us. The next one is what? Wa husni ibadatik. And help us, O Allah, to improve our ibadah towards you. Subhanallah. And this is being read out after every salah. For only if you knew this, what's the content of the dua, then it certainly works wonders for us to change, to transform to a true servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the banners of dua is mentioned in this surah. Allah mentioned about what? Invoke your Lord with humility. Raising your voice, humility, feel the humbleness. And then feel as if you are worried that Allah won't accept your dua. My brothers and sisters, I would like to share again how Sayyidina Ibrahim make his dua when he fulfill what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala request from him to build the foundations of Kaaba. And mention about Kaaba, now is the month of Dhul Hijjah, something to do with Hajj. Okay. Subhanallah. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلِ. And mentioned when Ibrahim was raising the foundation of the house with Ismail, it's actually the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, Sayyidina Ibrahim doesn't say, I've completed what you asked me to, O Allah. That's it. But the ayat reflected how Sayyidina Ibrahim make dua, subhanallah, with his sincere heart continuously. He said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayat number 127, Rabbana taqabbal minna. O Allah, accept from us what we have did, in what being asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innaka, innaka antas samiul alim. Indeed, you, all hearing, as samiul alim, and all knowing. Now observe, just listen to the way our Sayyidina Ibrahim make dua. Rabbana taqabbal minna. Very important for us to really observe what Sayyidina Ibrahim said when he built the foundation of Kaaba. O Allah, accept from us what we have did. Accept from us what we have did. Now, if you were to recall back, Prophet Adam, he has two sons, Qabil wa Habil. And this Qabil and Habil, we heard before, was asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make sacrifices. And the irony is that both of them make sacrifices. Both of them fulfill that. But it's just that Allah accepted one of them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disregard the other brother. So both of them are actually fulfilling what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked from them. And one is accepted, one is not accepted. If you were to really make tadabur on these two stories, why Sayyidina Ibrahim said, Rabbana taqabbal minna, O Allah, accept from us. When we make ibadah, we are fulfilling our ibadah. But have we pondered for a moment, does Allah accept our ibadah? Because if you recall back the story of Qabil wa Habil, both of them make their sacrifices to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is accepted, one is not accepted. At the end of the day, one killed the other one, subhanallah. So likewise, have we for a moment recall back, does Allah accept my prayer, earlier on, dhuhr prayers? Yes, we fulfill that. So that's the important invocation when Allah said, tadarru'a wa khufya. Invoke to Allah, supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make dua to Allah in such feel humbleness and hope for acceptance by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, Sayyidina Ibrahim make dua, Rabbana waja'alna muslimaini laka wa min dhurriyatina ummatan muslimatan lak wa arina manasikana wa tub 'alaina innaka antat tawwabur rahim. O our Lord, O Allah, Make us Muslims in submission to you. Who said this? This is reflected in Surah Al-Baqarah. Who actually making this dua? Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. The way Sayyidina Ibrahim make his dua is an example for us to follow how we can make dua like the prophets. How is our manners towards invoking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That feeling of total humility. Oh our Lord, make us Muslim. Rabbana waja'alna muslimaini. Both of us Muslim. Submission to you from the descendants of Muslim nation. And show us our rights and accept our repentance. Subhanallah. Watuba alayna. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam asking Allah, oh Allah, accept our repentance. The first one, it was accept what I have done. The next dua, oh Allah, accept my repentance. Innaka anta at-tawwabur rahim. Now, the phrase here, subhanallah, the phrase here, innaka anta at-tawwabur rahim, is repeated twice, we've heard twice right now. The first one says, innaka anta as-sami'ul alim. The second one, innaka anta at-tawwabur rahim. It is actually an emphasis of dua. Innaka indeed you, anta you, the oft returning, the most merciful. And he continued his dua, Rabbana wa ba'ath fihim rasulam minhum yatslu alayhim ayatika wa yu'allimuhumul kitaba wal hikmah wa yuzakkihim innaka antal azizul hakim. Again, continuation of his dua, Sayyidina Ibrahim, our Lord, send among them a messenger from themselves who will recite to them your verses and teach them the book and wisdom and purify them. Indeed, innaka antal azizul hakim. You, O Allah, are the most exalted, the most wise. So, the way we make dua in this month of Dhul Hijjah, so that we can get the best of reward for Allah's love for those who good deeds, to do good deeds in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, of course, we'll be continuing to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Comes with a sinsiat. So, I would like to reiterate myself, remind myself, let us reflect back all this while. Are we making dua or are we reading dua? Because once you make dua, it comes from the heart. When you read dua, it's just from your lisan. So, Sayyidina Ibrahim making dua from his heart. Really ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is the most significant act of ibadah in Arafah that we're going to pray for our loved ones over there? They are making dua in Arafah so that Allah accepted their hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. A little touch on the book of manners in dua. We'll continue inshallah 2 weeks time, because next week will be our Eidul Adha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all your sacrifices, all your ibadah. May Allah group us among the true servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we follow the significance and the sunnah of sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr, illa alladhina amanu wa amilus salihat wa tawassaw bil haqq wa tawassaw bis sabr. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.